Thank you for joining me today.
Oh, thank you for your time. I greatly, greatly appreciate that. I mean, I'm honored that you are interviewing me. When Mindy told me, I'm like, what? Mine too.
Well, you have a wonderful story. And what I'd really love for you to do is just kind of walk me through that, if you would. Now, what city are you in?
Oh, I am in Burlingame, San Mateo area, which is just south of San Francisco, the right. Peninsula.
And you've been in real estate how long?
20 years now.
So your business last year, you did what? Your volume was 40 something million?
45 million.
Yeah, that's a lot of real estate. And your GCI was what?
So it was almost 125 million to 50.
And do you work alone or do you have help?
No, unfortunately, I work alone. I have a really tiny team. The team is really my TC. I love her. She's been with me for 4 years, going on 5 years. She's wonderful. And my husband used to be a professor, but he recently joined me. I would say maybe 6 months or so now that he joined me. So that's as an operations manager. So that's me. That's my team. That's about it.
So in 2019, it was just you and your transaction coordinator.
Absolutely. Yep. I didn't have anybody else. Yeah.
So just tell us your story. So how do you build a business like that?
Well, you know, I think I come from social work background, and I think that had a lot to do with my success. I give, you know, quite a bit of importance or credit to that, because when I was a social worker, one of the things that they taught us is, you know, you need to stop and listen. Mm. And as you say, Gary, that as a real estate agent, we have a tendency of talking a lot, you know, and sometimes maybe lecturing. But when I came from the social work and listening to you two, is like, you need to stop, you need to listen, and if it's needed, you need to validate. And I think that has helped me a lot. The other thing I think helped me is I try to build the expectation and how we are going to work, me and my clients going to work as a team, from the very beginning. So they're not surprised how it's all going. So they know what to expect from the very beginning. So then it becomes easier. So So one thing I'll tell you is I don't have a lot of patience. I really don't. So, and I know that about myself. So when I meet with my clients, especially if it's buyers, because buyers sometimes can take long, and I don't want to tell them that, you know, I'm not going to work with you more than 3 months, because you better be buying within 3 months. But I take a different approach, and like, the more you look, the more you're going to lose. And in our area right now, and has been till 2013, the market is going up. So the more they wait, the more they lose. What the house that they would have bought it this year or this month for whatever amount, next month, it probably they're going to pay another 50K, 200K more. So it's their loss. So I set all of those up at the very beginning. And so I think that's what kind of probably helps me to do as much transaction, because I really work with my buyers maximum 2 months. I show them 3-4 properties, maybe 5. We get into a contract and we are done.
Mm. So how do you generate the leads to do that much business?
When COVID didn't happen, one thing I was very good at is open house. Okay. I got a lot of my clients from open house. again, I think it comes from the social work background. I meet people, I talk to people, and they just feel comfortable. And, you know, and what I do is when I meet with them, I have, you know, my interview is a little bit different with my buyers and my sellers. Like, I take time. My first interview with them is anywhere 1.5 to 2 hours. So I really want to know them, not just, okay, what do you want in a home? But I want to know their lifestyle. I want to know who they are, because everybody buys from lifestyle. So when I know their lifestyle, I can show them and I can take them to the places that I know will fit their lifestyle. And I think that's one of the key. So open house was one. I am building my referral base. That's my goal, to build my referral base. So I'm also, I keep in touch with my past clients, fear of influence. So that's my second, I think, you know, the second way of getting clients. And then I have a huge geo farm. Well, I don't know if it's huge, but I have a geo farm that I've been doing that for the last 20 years. So, and I have expanded the firm as well. And a lot of people just see my signs there. So they just call me up from my signs. So it's really three main sources. But, you know, things have changed because of COVID this year.
Yeah. So do you still do open house?
No, we are not allowed to do open house. But what I do is virtual open house.
Okay.
So, yeah. So what I do is I usually I do two ways. One is live Facebook. Sometimes it's great. Sometimes it's not. You cannot always depend on it. So what I started to do is I do a pre-recording, go to the house and record the so-called open house as if people are there, and I act like, and then I do a Zoom open house, and that has been more successful. So I advertise it everywhere, social media and websites everywhere. And that has been quite successful. People do follow the Zoom open house.
Yeah, they do, don't they? So what's the trick to doing that well?
Well, I think, and I think it was, you know, you brought in a Facebook, I think a few weeks ago on Top 100, and we talked about that. I think it's the, you can't just do the normal. You have to have a tagline or something that attracts people that to come and look at your open house. Like the recent, one of the recent open house I'm going to do, and I advertised it, is like, you don't want to come and see this house unless. So when you have taglines like this, I think it really brings, because now, especially with COVID, we can't be face to face. So, and social media has become so important that you really need to attract people, but not just like normal taglines. You have to come up with ways of doing it. The other, I had a house in Burlingame, and I had three houses at that time, and that was right after the COVID, and off having a home office became so important. So what I did is we did a video where my husband helped me to do the video, and we had like different celebrities put different celebrities' pictures, like, you know, Oprah, and I did a kind of like a recording, just a home recording. And then Michael, my husband, kind of spliced it up together, and it was fantastic. And we put that on the social media, had a Zoom open house with that. And it was fabulous. People loved it because it was just not the regular, okay, here is the house and here are the pictures and here are the videos and I'm going to have an open house. Everybody's doing that. So you kind of have to change it.
Yeah, that's
so exactly. I try to do things like that. Yeah. Out of the box.
So tell me something I don't know. Make me smart. I'm listening to you, and I want to build a business like you. So tell me what was your biggest challenge this year that you overcame, that you figured out and solved?
I think the biggest challenge was really at the lead, getting the lead this year, because my lead was really coming from open. A lot of lead were coming from open house. So that wasn't happening.
Yeah.
So my biggest challenge was getting the lead. So when we shut down in March, and we kind of talked about it, and we figured out this is all going to go digital. So what we did the month of March, as you encouraged us, there's two things we did. One is I just hunkered down and started calling my past clients and sphere of influence to make sure, and not, as you mentioned, not asking for business, but just telling them I'm here for them, how they're doing. That helped a lot, Gary, because it was amazing. And I kept on doing it. And it's amazing the people I haven't heard from. And thank you for telling us to do so. I mean, they have given me referrals this year that I haven't heard from them for a long time. But making those phone calls, I got quite a bit of referrals from, because what I, as you mentioned, what I did it is, you know, I became a part of their life. So that helped. So that's number one. Number two, what I really did is transferred everything into digital. Like I used to do a listing presentation. I used to had a nice portfolio that I used to go carry it and open it up and show it. It completely went digital. And then what I did is I hired, even though I cut down a lot of expenses this year, because as you told us at the very beginning, just make sure that you look at your expenses and do, you know, red light and green light. So that's what I did. Also, that's another thing, cut down a lot of, I think I cut down like 62% of my business expense this year. But one of the things, what I did is I hired a great marketing consultant and a great designer to do my website and also digitally put my listing presentation. And she is just fabulous. She's the one who designed the tap. That you pay. Okay. So she really designed my whole listing presentation, because the one of the thing I wanted to do this year also to raise my price point. Mm-hmm. So in order to do that, I had to have a different look, different feel. And so we did all of these things when I didn't have much to do, when we were not allowed to go out and meet clients and things like that. And that really helped a lot. So when things started opening up and I started getting phone calls, I just went into Zoom, did my listing presentation, did my buyer consultation, and all through Zoom. And it's really, I love the digital, to be very honest with you, especially for listing presentation, because now I can show way more things, like how my video works. Mm-hmm. How I'm more innovative on doing different styles of videos than the just regular videos.
That's more effective. I mean, you can be more effective, can't you, in that regard?
Absolutely. So, and so what I'm seeing is when I'm doing all these, I'm getting way more. This year, my referral business has gone up quite a bit because people are calling me, giving me referrals, the buyers that I have helped this year and the sellers too, when they're seeing how differently I am marketing the houses since I don't have open houses. And they are then giving referrals to other, that the people that they know that they're on the market to sell. So social media is helping me a lot this year. And I'm really ramped up my social media presence in social media and trying to do, again, not something that everybody does, trying to do something that is catches people's attention.
So when you look at 2021, what do you think is going to happen?
With my business?
Yeah.
It's going to be way better.
And why is that?
Because what I'm doing is I'm using what you talk about is life by design. And so I'm planning from life by design. So I wanna make sure we already started working on that, is that I know where I want to be. And then I am coming up with my business plan accordingly. So I know how much transactions I have to do. I know we're probably not going to have open house next year either. At least the first half of it probably could be the whole year. I don't know. So I am also preparing for that as well, how I'm going to be different than other agents that are doing business. I am doing two things next year, a little bit different. I started door knocking at the beginning of my career, but I'm not a door knocker at all. But but what I did is I ordered the chip clips with my information, and we have I have a buyer letter, and I did a letter for thank you as a seller. So when I have houses coming on the market or recently came on the market, we are going around the whole neighborhood, and instead of knocking, we have a letter that says, thank you so much for referring some of clients to this, you know, to this listing. Thank you for calling and inquiring. Some of you have called and inquired about the house. Some of you have given me information regarding some potential buyers. Thank you for doing that. And, you know, if you know anybody who's thinking of selling, you know, I'm here. So that kind of letter I'm doing. So I started to do that and give it to the, drop it off the bigger neighborhoods. Mm-hmm. I'm also doing, I have a buyer letter, and I am going to, I bought 20, the Millionaire Real Estate Investor book, mm-hmm. your book. And I am going to give 20 of them as a gift to some of my clients who I know are thinking of potentially doing an investment. And I'm going to create a Facebook group with those 20 of my clients that I'm giving. And I'm going to have kind of like a Facebook meeting, live meeting, once quarterly or once a month, you know, depending on how everybody wants to do it. Everybody's life is, you know, busy, but at least quarterly, and maybe bring in some guests, talk about what they want to know, you know. So I want to have more engagement with, so I'm doing some.
I like that.
Yeah. Things that I think hopefully will help me out to bring more business.
Okay, final thoughts. What do you want to tell me that I didn't ask you, that you think would help anybody that's listening to this?
So one thing I think, you know, and that's just something I feel very strongly, is the value that we bring in for our clients. What I mean by that is when I represent a seller, my commission is always 6%. Mm. I will literally walk away from any listing that they're not going to give me 6%. Doesn't happen much, but it once in a while happens. But I really feel, Gary, that I bring in a certain value, and I only want to work with people who understand what I can do for them, and also understand the value of the service and the value of the money. I really don't want to work with anybody that's a discount person. So, and I think we just have to believe in ourselves and be confident what we can do. And that's something that I really try to also talk to newer agents who are always afraid that if I don't give money away, and it's kind of like a slippery slope. Once you start it, you know, there is no way of out. So, but if you hold your standard at the very beginning from day one here, you might struggle a little bit at the beginning, but eventually you will not.
Right.
And I think that's the value and the confidence I think that I try to bring in and I try to instill with newer agents, because I think we, in this, it, at least in our area, I feel like that we keep on giving more and more discount. You know, we start giving more and more discount. And I think it's kind of sad. We are giving a different message. And I don't really like that. You know, we are very valuable. We bring in our expertise. They have to be able to rely on us and we have to be able to deliver. And in order for us to do that, we have to believe in our value. Otherwise, we cannot provide value.
I love that. All right, dear. Perfect. Thank you so much for your time and for sharing.
Thank you so much, Gary.